Let's look at what the forward Euler method does to this equation. X after the first step will be the initial value of x plus the time step times the rate of change at the initial time plus the rate of change at time zero. What's the rate of change at time zero? It's minus kx of zero. We can factor out x of zero and end up with this expression. That's the result after the first time step. The initial value gets multiplied by 1 minus step size times the constant that appears in the test equation. Now let's do the second step. It's x at the end of the previous step plus h times the rate of change at that time, or actually our estimate of that rate of change at that time, which would be minus kx of h. Again, we can factor out. And we can plug in the value of x of h from the first step. So we end up with 1 minus hk times, now comes x of h, 1 minus hk times x of 0, which is, if we combine these two, 1 minus hk squared x of 0. And you see how this is going to proceed. If we go to 3h, this will become 4h power of 4, and so on. The question was whether or not x is going to approach zero. This boils down to whether or not 1 minus hk to the nth power approaches zero as n tends to infinity. So what happens to the nth power of 1 minus hk? We are interested in how large h, the step size, can be. If the step size h gets large, the expression inside the parenthesis becomes negative. We are subtracting from 1. If we are subtracting more than 1, the inner term here gets negative. So the question is, what happens to powers of negative numbers, to some huge power? As an example, what happens if the inner expression equals minus 2 and we take the first, second, third, fourth, and so on power? Minus 2 to the first power is minus 2. Minus 2 to the second power squared is 4. The third power cubed is minus 8. The fourth power is 16, and so on. Which means that this expression, the nth power, would explode. This is precisely not what we want for a stable solution. So let's try a different number. So what would happen if the inner expression was minus 0.9 and we took powers of minus 0.9? The first power is, surprise, minus 0.9. The second power is 0.81. The third power is minus 0.7 something. The fourth power is 0.6 something. Each time we're losing 10% in magnitude, but you see that the sign keeps changing. Minus, plus, minus, plus. So this indeed decays to zero, but in a strange fashion. It oscillates. You may remember this behavior from the SEIR model that we simulated before. If this expression would equal minus 0.99, we would still see decay with this sort of oscillation. If it would equal minus 0.999, this would still work, but become very, very slow. So the threshold would be that 1 minus hk, this inner expression, equals minus 1. The threshold, it's 2 over k. So the condition is that h is smaller than 2 over k for this power to decay to zero and for the forward Euler method to be stable.